Everybody, how y'all doing? Happy Thursday, Friday Eve. One more day and it's the weekend. Thank the Lord. Past 2 days at work have been, well, dead. D-E-D, dead. I'd rather be as busy as it was last week, because at least when I get home, I'm not dead tired when there's like nothing to do at work. I don't know about you guys. If it's slow, it just sucks. But probably going to be that way another week before we get busy again. Another small tour rolls in to prepare. So, yeah, we'll be doing good. Left off last night, finishing night one, explicit one recorder with one EVP, two EVPs. Two EVPs out of six or four sections. We've done worse, we've done better, is what it is. So tonight, we are actually on to explicit one, night two. Not sure where it's at. We're going to give it a few minutes. I still have 10 more beans to do from MDS's donation, gifted subs last night. There, managed to get that out in one sentence. I don't know how, but I did. Again, hope you guys had a good day. Just kind of ready to get this week over with. Got a little bit to do this weekend. Beyond that, if it's dead here at home, I might just pop on and do a weekend show. Haven't decided yet. Still got a day to go to see if that happens. But anyways, hope you guys got your headphones on, something cold to drink, someplace comfortable to sit. We're going to give it about 15 minutes, then we'll do the beans. But let's get on to Explicit One, Night Two. All right, this is Brent with Incarnate Paranormal. This is Nevada State Prison, Night Two, Visit Four. This is Explicit One recorder being left in seven, I don't know, 7D being left, I don't know. D in the rotunda on the bench. And this is Explicit One. All right. Building seven, wing D on the bench. Keep it closed. We're gonna find out here in a second. We might already have an EVP. I doubt it, but we're gonna check it. Okay, apply. Get some vocal enhancers in there. And let's see. No. Let's try this again. Apply reduction. I don't think we can I don't think we can count this. So started off a minute in with a debunk. Now let's see how many hours of silence we get. Gotta be careful, guys. I kind of tweaked my shoulder and my neck today. So turning to the right sucks. Gonna be a little hard to get comfortable tonight, too. You're gonna see me popping my back a lot and stretching. Seven seems to have the most echo out of all the buildings up top. We've got some areas we might have, you know, some potential evidence. Definitely don't know yet. Do know we've got over 6 hours of audio on this recorder. Wait, that's one night. 18 hours. Hold on. Out of my freaking headphone cord. Jack wanted to come up and say hi to everybody. Didn't you, bud? Are you crying, bud? You okay? See your eye. There you go, bud. But he had something on his eye. Say hi to everybody, Jack. What's up, Moose? See, bud? People are saying hi to you. Hey, you got something on your eye, bud. There you go. How you doing, Moose? Haven't had Jack shed this much in a while. A little sore today. Kind of tweak my back a little bit. My back and my shoulder. Still got all those beans to do too that MDS did with the gifted subs. Got 10 more, I already got them set to the side. I can turn all the way to the left, but I turn to the right, I get about a half a turn with my neck, and it hurts. It's like, oh well, shit happens, my own fault. So what we're gonna do, you guys could see, here's the rest of the beans left from last night. Okay, those were fucking spicy. An inflamed bunion? Ouch. Ooh. Okay, that sucked. Now my nose is gonna start running. Ooh, yeah, excuse me a second. Sorry, I had to blow the nose. Some water. Okay, a little better. Ooh. This batch is the spiciest of all the batch. This is like my fourth batch of beans altogether, and these are the spiciest of the bunch. And it's like, what, 75 today and like 50 mile an hour winds. So it's a beautiful day. Very beautiful day. Just too windy. That really kicks up the sinuses. Sucks when you have bad allergies. So allergies on top of spicy right now. Brent is not an intelligent man. Yeah, in about a month it'll be like 90 in a month. I would take the 44 over 75 and windy. Don't get me wrong, I don't mind the wind, but not 50 mile an hour winds. Had to go out today in the box truck and wind, it sucks. And I have a Jeep, so driving home in the wind in a Jeep, you're almost going sideways down the road. Hopefully we can get at least one EVP out of section one. Either way, have fun with it. We definitely have a couple areas way up at the end that have some potential. Like right in there, that looks like it could be something. That's probably a semi. I was talking with a couple people at work today, too, about, you know, the paranormal. One of them wants to go to the prison in September. Well, I don't want to drive that far. By the time you get a flight, get a rent-a-car, get your hotel, it's going to be cheaper than driving. Well, it's like, if you're going to make excuses, just don't go. I got to get on my team here this weekend and be like, okay, guys, I need answers. Because I'm not going to hold a spot until the last minute and just have you not go. Because, let's see, it's April, May, June, July, August, September. We're 5 months out. I'm not paying for them. They're not even going to ride with me from the airport. I'm getting my flight day early, get back to the hotel, charge up all my shit, rest the first day, wait for Deds and his girl to get in for Thursday, the first night. I'm not messing around with this. We're all freaking adults. That's traffic, but that's weird. I've never heard that before. Oh, well. Yeah, I think it is metal of some kind. Not paranormal, but metal. Is that bugs? That's bugs. That's a fucking fly. That's the first fly we've ever caught. We've seen bugs on camera. I gotta mark the fly. Okay, we'll mark it. Okay, no evidence, just a fly. Gotta throw some comedy in there, you really do. So when we did women's, we got the mouse on camera. And in Building 7, we got flies on recorder. And we've got Jasper a lot, too. Excuse me. We've got more Wild Kingdom then we have evidence. That's pretty bad. They have their very own Green Mile Mouse. Yeah? Green Mile had Mr. Jingles. And what can we name this mouse? No idea. Yeah, I did too. Somebody said Mickey Mouse. It's like, no. I think that was Nick that said Mickey Mouse. Nevada Mouse? Eh. You got in a Nevada State Prison. Really don't want to name him Nevada Mouse. Name him Willie. Willie the Mouse. So probably what I'm going to do tonight, since my back is toasted, is call it in an hour tonight. At least we get in, we get some audio done, and I can go put some Icy Hot on my back or something. Because it is uncomfortable for me to sit right now. Yeah, after about an hour mark, I'm going to. At least we get an hour in, we get some audio done, and I can't say I just flaked on the show. Because I was this close to it. Then it's like, I still got beans to do tonight. And we got to start the new section. So yeah. I messed with him at work today too. We have a basketball hoop for break, and my back was, you know, really acting up. And it's like, Brent, you shouldn't be doing this. You know, you kind of tweaked your back. I said, no, I'm just getting old. I can still show all you kids up. It's like, they're like, what? It's like, I'm 48. You guys are in your 20s, and I'll still run circles around you. And they just gave me that look. It's like, you're crazy. It's like, you really don't want to do this. You've got youth and inexperience between age and rage. Which one you think's going to freaking win? And we have a couple of the guys, they're like 22, 23 years old. Hey, Brent, let's go drinking. Not a good idea. I even told him, it's like, not bright. It's like, don't challenge me to drink. I said, I'll be going and you guys will be passed out in the back seat or in an alley somewhere because I won't take you home. When we passed out drinking, we pretty much got left where we laid. You're at a buddy's house, you pass out in the backyard, they might be nice and throw a blanket on you. I did that in my buddy's backyard. They didn't bother moving me. I passed out on a hill of fire ants. And they didn't move me. They let me blackout drunk sleep on fire ants. I woke up the next morning covered in them. I was not happy. Only way to get it, I jumped right in the pool. Oh, that's tame compared to what we used to do to each other. Ain't nobody backing out. Once we start, it doesn't stop till the last person goes to sleep. And Moose, don't tell me you and your friends didn't do the same to each other. Somebody blacks out, you draw on them with a Sharpie. Draw a nice great big dick on the side of their face. Yeah, we were not nice to each other. Never done that to me, but to a few others we have. Nice friends. The best of friends. I've told the story of what we did to my narcoleptic friend. I think I've told that story a couple times on the show. What we did to him, he disappeared for a couple weeks. Usually I was too. And I was drinking double everybody else. This recorder, lame. Remember one buddy, he was narcoleptic. So he'd pass out with a beer in his hands. We all got, this is a different group I was hanging out with. He got so drunk he passed out. And because he was narcoleptic, once he was asleep, he was asleep. He passed out on the couch like this. So we put flowers in his hands like you dressed him up like he was dead. We all pretty much teabagged him, took a picture of it, printed it out, and hung it on the door at the bar we all went to. Of our blacked out, teabagged friend, we posted the picture at the bar. He didn't come around for a while. buddies. I would say I doubt that. You'd think there'd be at least a residual in here somewhere. I remember one of my buddies, he was Air Force, and he had a bottle of soju that he had brought back from Korea with him, and he finally decided to open it during a poker game. Two of us killed that entire bottle. Never again. My uncle had a bet if he passed out first, I would get to shave his head. If I passed out first, he could shave my beard. We got the same of some of his buddies. Yeah, they look pretty funny with bald heads. Nice. I have a picture somewhere of one of our buddies that we drew on when he passed out. See if I could find it. This was a group I used to, a country group, a bunch of my redneck friends that I hung around. Not too good of a picture, but this is what we did to them. This was just the start of what we did to him. Yeah, he's, after we did that to him, he basically stopped hanging around us. It's like, dude, it was a joke. That's fucked up, guys. Sorry. Have thicker skin? I've mentioned the story about playing beer pong. I think I've told this one a few times on here. A good friend of ours, her son, wanted to drink with the big boys for his 21st birthday. All he could do was talk shit about kicking our butts in beer pong. And his mom kept telling him, these guys have been doing this every weekend for years. My uncle was always trying to bet me when drinking. He never learned with drinking with me. I don't drink against my family. I learned that the hard way. I lost royally. But this kid, you know, 21, it's like, I can beat you guys drinking. I'll beat you guys in beer pong. You know, we'll go shot for shot. I'll win every time. Finally, everybody just got tired of it. And his mom just looked it up and goes, teach him a lesson. It's like, and once you tell guys like me to teach somebody a lesson, they're never going to forget it. So he wanted, we told his mom, you cannot be mad at us for what we're about to do. He wanted to play beer pong with Jack Daniels. He wanted to do shots with beer pong. We did everything in our power to stop this kid. You're gonna have a bad night. You're gonna be sick. You're gonna be puking. You're not gonna enjoy the party. Just do it with beer. Man, F you guys, we're doing it with Jack. Or what are you, pussies? It's like, everybody kind of just looked at me and go, Brent, you deal with this. All right, I got you guys. He's like, you going first? It's like, okay. Boom, boom. Two balls, same cup. I said, drink them all, game's over. Walked outside. He had to drink the full rack on both sides. That we used to play two balls, same cup, you shoot it all. I two balls, same cup, and I walked away. He's standing there going, wait. It's like, you talked all this shit, drink it, or go home. His mom did not talk to me for 6 months. After her son was blacked out under the beer pong table. We were playing beer pong with his blacked out ass under the beer pong table. We put a freaking salad bowl next to him and Casey puked. We kept on with the party. He was blacked out under the table. Everybody thought I was a little fucked up for ending it in the first two balls. Whoa, hold on. Traffic, never mind. But yeah, they're like, Brent, why didn't you give him a chance? You heard all the shit he was talking. You said take care of him. And they're like, yeah, you're right. Mom was like, Brent, why'd you have to do it that way? You said teach him a lesson. He'll never do it again. And he didn't. Like, and like what we tried telling this kid, we played beer pong tournaments every weekend at the bar. It's like $25 buy-in, I think it was. You had like 12 teams. Third place gets free beer the next weekend. Second place got like $50. First place got like $250. And my buddy and I, we were first or second like almost every week. It was like we were top of the bar. It's like, I remember one time when we won the one of the beer pong tournaments we won, and I was just joking around. My buddy's like, dude, just get this game over with. Last cup, I did a Michael Jordan fadeaway jumper, sank it in the cup. The guy wanted a box. My buddy and I ended up at a party one night with kids younger than us, and a few kids challenged us to beer pong, won every game, and they're like, fuck this, we don't want to play with you two old dudes. I wish kids nowadays would realize that before doing it. Life has fucked us in more ways than they'll ever imagine. We've been through the trenches drinking. From 14 years old, drinking Mad Dog 2020 at a buddy's house, and we paid some homeless guy to buy us at the liquor store, and they're freaking drinking White Claw. We grew up with Boone's Farm. We grew up with Mad Dog. You know, you grow up with Boone's Farm, you remember being sick on that. like, just no. Okay, that's metallic. Yeah, they want to play with kids their own age, so they think they can have a chance. Boone's, Mad Dog, and PBR. We weren't doing PBR. We were doing malt liquor. St. Ides, Mickey's, Old English, Colt 45. Mainly like Mickey's. Mickey's was number one. 15 years old carrying around a 40 of Mickey's. The wide mouth Mickey's bottles. You know which ones I'm talking about, Moose. The short little barrel Mickey's with the wide mouth. Those things were the shit back in the day. Like, and I'll go ahead and say, there used to be a liquor store here in Vegas. It's still open. They didn't care how old you were. They would sell you alcohol. All that, you could show them your junior high student ID and they would sell to you. As long as you showed them any form of identification, they sold to you. You could show them a library card. As long as it had your picture on it, they sold to you. With a bag of beer. Yep. I remember being 16 going to this liquor store. I think the first time I went to that liquor store, I was like 14. Junior high ID. They're like, okay, thank you. Like, what? They're like, you can go. It's like, all right. Moose has his bag of beer. And everybody be like, can I have one? Nope. This is my beer. If she was cute, maybe she would get one. If she was cute, okay. If she was ugly, you drink those beers until she's cute, then maybe she'll get one. If the boys asked for one, you didn't put in on this. Go get your own. I ended up at a high school party one night at my neighbor's house. I'm in my mid-30s. The kids were like, can I have one of your beers, please? Hell no. Nah. Yeah. Said, one of the girls' houses I investigated. She's mid-20s, and I did this, what, about 4 years ago, so about 44, 43, 44, and after we did a couple investigations there, hold on, and she invited me to stay and party with her friends after the investigation. These kids are in their 20s. And it's like, all right, I'll stay. Maybe one of your friends is cute, but the girl who I investigated, oh my God, was she smoking fucking hot. Freaking Persian girl? Oh, she's, yeah. But now, I mean, and this, let me pause this real quick for this one. When we were in grade school, junior high, we look back at people that were our age now, and it was like, they looked in their 50s and 60s. You look at the kids now, at when we were teenagers, early 20s, you look at kids now at that same age, they look like they're 14 fucking years old. It's like, are you serious? And they're trying to show off, be like, yeah, I gotta go. Wait, it's like, you're not 18 yet, right? Yeah, I gotta go. Pretty much they were acting like Stewart. Look what I can do. Look what I can do. Look what I can do. Yeah, no. I gotta go. It's like, you do realize I have more hair on my face than you do down there. This ain't gonna work. Yeah, 15 will get you 20. You see the girls now and they're in their 20s and you're like, damn. It's like, ooh. Yeah. And now they're just really getting into the drama portion of their lives. Like, you may be hot, but you got too much fucking drama for me. Life hasn't even begun to do them in the dirty side. And like I said, we're going to hit that hour mark and, oh, yeah, I got to go get something for my back. It's really freaking knotting up. This gaming chair does not do good for it. Moose, I appreciate you being here tonight and anybody else lurking in the shadows. Greatly appreciate it. Should be back same time tomorrow night, hopefully. guys, have a great night. God bless, and I'll see y'all later. Thanks again.